Hi everyone, it is Dena from Miladyleela.com, and today I'm sitting in my wardrobe and I'm going to do a video for you that I've been wanting to do for a very long time, and I just haven't been able to get to it. So today is the day, and before we get started, I encourage you to go ahead and grab your favorite cuppa. I am having some water in this beautiful goblet. I'm almost finished with it because I've been filming a few videos. One of which I filmed before this one, and I ended up having to delete it because it didn't work. Something happened with YouTube. There was a glitch in the streaming, and I'm just not going to refilm it. It was about empties. We'll just have to get to it another time. So, with that being said, today's video is going to be about a traveling altar, and this is from Magic on the Go, and this is something that I put together a very long time ago, and I am so in love with it. I encourage everyone to do something like this so that whenever you are out and about, if you're going on a picnic or you're going for a little day trip and you want to have some quiet time and just get into your meditation, this is the perfect thing for you. So I have put together my traveling altar in this beautiful little wooden box, and there is a picture that you can insert inside here. So there's a glass frame, and I have right here inserted a picture of Lily of the Valley, which is my flower for the month of May. I was born in the month of May, for those of you that didn't know, and that is my flower. So very earthy indeed. So I thought that I would put that there. And I have not actually had the opportunity, you guys, to even use this traveling altar because for the last 2 years, we've been very, very busy taking care of my mother-in-law. And I haven't been able to leave the house. I've been busy taking care of her. And I haven't had time for meditation or anything. So it is now time to get back to me and get back to the things that I enjoy doing that make me who I am and give me pleasure and joy. And so we're actually going to be opening this up today together, and I'm going to be reminiscing the things that I put inside it. So that's exciting. And here we go. So I have this beautiful ribbon. It's an organza green ribbon. It matches the, sorry about the glare, it matches the beautiful image on the front. And then I'm going to open the box. So inside, I have a bunch of treasures. And this is super exciting. Okay. So inside here, I have a baggie, and this is filled with some mugwort from my garden. And this was from the garden over at the castle. I also have a charcoal disc inside here so that I can burn it. And in order to burn it, I have this little receptacle. Now, I currently have a couple of things in here. Bear with me. So this is a little place that I can set incense on or my herbs, and I can burn what it is that I am intending to burn. So I have my mugwort and a charcoal disc. I also have another charcoal disc, which I wrapped in parchment paper. And then I have, oh, sage. I love this. This is white sage, and I definitely need to be doing some smudging very soon. I have some more mugwort and salts and some, it looks like, oh, some shells and some mugwort and some herbs and flowers in this little baggie. So I can sprinkle that around on the ground, or I can burn it on my little tray. I have a cute little piece of ivy. This is a piece of faux ivy. I have some lavender oil. Now, these are just items that I like to use in my practice. And you can put whatever you want in your traveling altar, but these are just things, and I hope I'm inspiring you with some ideas of items that you can put in yours. And you can set your intentions and do whatever it is that you wish with these herbs and flowers. It doesn't necessarily need to be for a specific, like, for example, mugwort has its own values and properties. But if you like mugwort and you envision what it is that you're trying to do with your intentions and your spells, then all you really need to do is just use that particular flower, herb, or incense. It doesn't necessarily have to be what it's actually intended for. It's all what you make it and what you put into your practice. And that's very important to know. When you're just getting started, there's so much information out there and you almost feel compelled to actually follow all the directions. But as you work into your practice and just find out what resonates with you with love and light, then you can just basically use the items that smell good to you or you like to work with or that just totally resonate with you. Now, in this little parchment paper packet, I'm not sure what's in here because, like I said, it's been so long since I had a chance to get in here. Oh, this is dried lavender from my garden. And that is right here. I am all about lavender and rose, you guys. The herbs that I work with the most are, well, flowers are lavender and rose. And then I love working with sage, and I also love mugwort. I don't always have the ability to have mugwort in my garden, but I did have it at the castle, and I was also gifted a lot of it from my friend Robin. And all that you saw here in this little travel altar kit is all that I have left, so I totally covet that. I also have some cinnamon oil, and this is just from the brand Loran that you can actually use in food preparation or making cinnamon toothpicks. But I love this oil. It smells so good. So I have that also in my traveling altar. I also have some candles. And these are, let me just fix this up real quick. These are little birthday candles that I picked up from the Dollar Tree. And they're so fabulous, because they have these little bottoms so that if you're sitting outside, you can actually insert these right into the ground and work your workings. I would be very careful though, you know, if you have grass or leaves, you need to make sure that you're in a safe, safe space. So I'm not, little disclaimer here, I'm not telling you to go ahead and stick candles in the ground and set a fire. No, you have to be very, very careful. But if you are, like if you have some sand around or if you have dirt and there's nothing else around you, you could be very, very careful and you could light your candles. You can also carry a little clay candle holder to put your candles in. There's so many different ways that you can do it, but I do keep these so that if I'm in a space where it's safe to be able to light a candle, I can do that. So with that being said, I have those as taper candles. And I also have these little tea light candles. These are very nice to have so that you can put them in your little container, which right now I have my charcoal disc in and my sage, but you know what I'm talking about. You can just have that completely empty and just place your tea light inside your little candle holder and then sprinkle your herbs around it. And then lastly, I have this little match case. This particular one was created by a friend of mine, my friend Victoria. And so I have wooden matches inside here, which, you know, anything that is natural is really mostly welcomed when you're doing your practice because it's earthy. And she inspired me with these little match boxes to create my own. And I have made several of them and gifted them to some of my friends that also have love to light candles or like to do practice their meditation and such. So there's that. And then I have this beautiful doily, which I use as an altar cloth. So I can set everything right up here on top of my wooden box, just like that. And I have a beautiful and sacred, magical space whenever I travel and I'm not. And when I say travel, it doesn't necessarily mean traveling. It means just being away from home, or if you're in your backyard and you want to create a magical space around you for your meditation practice. And so that's what I have. Now I'm going to put everything back in and assemble it so that it closes up nicely. I'll show you what that looks like. And you, like I said, you can put whatever it is that you wish inside your travel altar. It feels really good to do a video like this too, you guys. I haven't done any of these types of videos in a very long time. I will link my Book of Shadows journey in the description box below. I have quite a few views on that, thousands of views actually, where I created all the pages in my original Book of Shadows. Now, my very first Book of Shadows was basically like a journal when I was just getting started in my magical practice, and I just wrote down a lot of information that I found online and in books. And one of these days I might do a video and show you all of the Book of Shadows I currently have. I think that would be a great video. If you're interested in that, let me know. Leave me a comment below. I have that very first one, and then I have the one that I designed, which is kind of like an art Book of Shadows, like an art journal style Book of Shadows. And then I have some inserts that I've created that are smaller insert Book of Shadows that ultimately I will be placing as I continue that collection and that collection grows into a bound book. So in the meantime, though, I have a few different ones that I've started. And I haven't even thought of the bound book yet that I will be placing them in. So I'm just making the inserts, and that's really fun to do as well. And I can show you those. So if you're interested in seeing my collection of my Book of Shadows, then just go ahead and leave me a comment. Let me know. Like this video too. And yeah, and I can get back to doing some of those videos. They were actually very well received, and I had, between that and my What's in My Handbag videos, those were like the best videos that get the most views for my channel. And and also talking about my Neutrogena body oil, that one people seem to really love as well. So I'm going to just go ahead and close this up with a beautiful bow. And I'm looking forward to the nice weather and getting outside and taking this beautiful traveling altar with me so that I can create a beautiful space of meditation, of love and light. And here she is. You can use any type of box or bag or anything that you want to put together. It's your discretion, however it is that you see fit. I just happen to really enjoy this box, and you know, it doesn't completely close. It just depends on how you put things in here and how much stuff you have, but the ribbon keeps it nicely compact together so that nothing falls out. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. It lets me know that you did and also helps out my channel greatly. I will leave the link to my Book of Shadows playlist. I have a plethora of information on that and I know that you will enjoy. And I will also link all of my social media links below. You can always check out miladyleela.com. That will be linked below to show you where I am everywhere on the net. But if you'd like to leave me a tip in my virtual tip jar, you can do so by my PayPal link, which is paypal.me/miladyleela. It really helps me to continue my journey here on YouTube and all of the things that I do in social media. And also, if you're interested, I do a Manifestation Monday Oracle Read podcast every single Monday on my Patreon page. And I also share my tried and true recipes, which I call kitchen spells that my family and myself really, really enjoys. And then a few other little kitchen spell things that I put together that have nothing to do with cooking. So if you're interested in that, it's only $1 a month, you guys. You can't even buy your favorite cuppa for $1 a month from your favorite coffee shop or tea shop. So I hope you join me there. All of the links will be below. And if you are new to my channel, welcome. Thank you for being here. If you have come back to my channel, I appreciate that you are back. Welcome back. And I love that you are spending your time here with me and allowing me to share my enchanting world with you. I wish you so much love, many, many blessings, and many friendships to come. And I will see you in my next video. Bye.